Once upon a time, there was a house named after a booth.
Booth House is my house in college.
Booth House is a cool place.
You're cool.
Hold on to me as we go. As we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone. Cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
My parents kind of pre-approved Jeremy for me.
Well, we met on the first day, no, Sunday, and all three of us became best friends right away.
I thought Sebastian was the most awkward kid the first couple of weeks. He was like so awkward following everyone around.
The first person I met was Kate, and we're like best friends right now, so that went well.
I don't know, everyone was talking, and I guess, like, I didn't really like the conversation, and I was just, like, looking around, and then I noticed that he didn't like the conversation either. And then we just, like, looked at each other, we just smiled, and then we just started talking.
Love at first sight.
And then I just kissed him, and we've been together ever since.
the procession to Holgate, I was just walking by myself, and then I happened to be by Jeremy and his family, and then his mom whispers into me in my ear, like, take care of each other as I, like, walked by.
I, like, thought Jane was, like, the scariest person. I didn't think she was scary, but, like, I just thought she was way too cool for me. And I just, like, couldn't approach her. But then, you know, we're, like, obviously very close now, so I appreciate that, too.
The Facebook group, I saw a picture of Chris and saw that he was going to be my RA, and gotta be honest, that picture of Chris was very derpy. I was nervous.
Oh yeah, we thought that Elcom's gonna be a huge douche. Not and I just talked about this like 2 days ago. Like, cause he had this like profile picture where he's like, and we were like, who is this kid?
Hello.
Yes.
Welcome to the comedy hour.
It's the remix to Ignition.
I didn't know there was a Booth House Facebook group, and I didn't know that there was a U Chicago Facebook group until like last week.
What?
Ellie and I ran around like searching for like secret like passageways and like running up staircases, and one of the first things we did was like open up like a window, like take off the screen, and then we went to the house meeting and they said, if you open a house like a window, you get kicked out of housing. And I was like, oh my god, I already like that's it, college is over.
So I walked into the lounge and asked them if anyone had a popcorn popper because I needed to prepare my drugs, and they looked horrified, and Christine said, well, the RMs might. And Natasha, for the sake of conversation, asked me, so what drugs do you use?
Yeah, so Chris, Elcom, and I, and Sebastian, we were walking to band in Logan, and this guy comes up on a bicycle behind us, and he's like, get out of the way! And we're like, oh, what the heck's happening? And he runs into Elcom, falls off his bike, and Elcom's like, Elcom, nicest guy. He's like, oh, shoot, is he okay? And he's like, I'm gonna have to help this guy. And then out of every direction, the police officers come and, like, arrest the guy on the ground, like, don't move! And the car comes, like, woo, 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 and, like, stops right in front of him. It was really intense. So Elcom is basically Batman.
Yeah. Certain someone in Booth happened to want to loft his bed because he did not have enough space. And so, you know, James, the certain someone, he's just, you know, he's been working out a lot, but he just can't quite pull the thing apart to put it back together. So he's got to enlist the help of some, you know, absurdly strong gentleman, and Al's off doing, you know, God knows what for Sig Chi. So he gets Mike and Ansi, you know, because they were out in the hall having a philosophical debate about Eastern Civ or something. What are they? And so they go in his room, and they're pulling apart the bed, they're, you know, hinging on this, and making a lot of noise. And Namrata's downstairs, and she's trying to, you know, take it easy. It's a Saturday night, you know. You know Namrata, she's really crazy, but sometimes she's gotta take it easy. So she's trying to take it easy, and she hears this creaking and thumping from James's room, which is right above hers. So she's curious, you know, who's having the crazy awesome sex, because, you know, she doesn't know who's up there. And so she comes up to find out what's going on. And Auntie walks out of James' room putting his shirt on.
Then Tess and Jelani have been awesome too. They're so motivated to help us out with everything. Really dedicated to make us have a great experience getting involved.
I think that Chris does a really good job too because he compliments Tessa and Jelani.
One of the first weeks, Chris promised us that there would be ice cream on the Sunday night. Yeah, and there wasn't any. I remember that.
This was also when I saw Chris asleep on the couch when I first met him.
So I was like one of the first Booth House people that our RA, Chris with a K, met.
I met him before you.
No, you didn't.
Yeah, I did.
Why? How? When?
He gave me a tour.
Oh! Aww! Family. But anyway, I met him, and then he messed up my name twice the following week. Even though I was like one of the first people he met. He called me Isabel, then he forgot my name. So heartbroken.
Yeah, Chris. He didn't remember me either from the tour. Somehow.
He like doesn't care about us that much. It's okay. Have you met Kelly? Kelly's wonderful.
That's okay, Chris. I really liked your Batman stamp.
I really like your, I'm sure you're a nice guy.
I mean, Chris isn't cool at all. He's a big loser, so not much to say about that guy. No, Chris has been awesome, better than I even could have expected. For a guy who spells Chris with a K, it's hard to be much of a person, but he needs to come into more sports next year. Stop being so flaky. You're not a biscuit, Chris. Be a man. Come to sports. First thing I see is the banner with the crazy derpy Booth Bear. What did I get myself into? But quickly I learned some really cool people in the house. And I think the Booth Bear is really emblematic of what people in Booth House are like. Derpy and pretty awesome.
And I have to say, it's probably the place where I've had the most like actual intellectual debates that require like serious thought. Which is somewhat surprising because I thought that'd be more things that happened in class, but it's definitely been more at the house table or in the lounge or just out in the world.
Oh, something that happened last week. You weren't there. So I was in the dining hall with a bunch of people, and Evan looks at me and goes, "So what would you do if it rained cheese?" Which makes sense if you know me, is a question really.
Oh, okay.
So yeah, he asked me that, and then that proceeded into a 40-minute conversation about the nature of cheese rain, in which Jacob looked up the density of feta cheese, and then people were, Carter asked about the solubility product of cheese, and it was like wonderful.
My favorite thing is when you go on like a Saturday morning and you see all of your friends and the table is just crowded and you're like, "Hey guys, how was your night?" And they're like, "It was really fun." And then they tell you like all these stories and it's so fantastic and it's like 9 a.m.
One of my favorite things, especially first and second quarter when everyone would hang out in the lounge until like 3 a.m. in the mornings on Fridays and Saturdays playing Smash, that was a lot of fun.
I think that the important thing about Booth House is that it's a unique community and that in order to fit in, you're just be yourself. Like there's a lot of communities I find in my life, like whether it's like a certain classroom or like certain groups of people where like to become like normal and to have a good time, you have to sort of like act like everyone else and you kind of talk like them. But in Booth House, it's this weird thing where like you have to be yourself as much as possible. And then in doing so, you sort of like make this beautiful community. And like, I think that's the reason why everyone likes it so much. And it's so accepting. Like, we have people living in this house with like such different opinions on lots of different things, and yet like we all like pile into the house table together and like it just works out.
I'm gonna miss the second years. You guys just seem to have like a nice unity within like the group. And so, like, I think that really helped, like, me and I think other first year just feel comfortable in Booth House.
It'll be interesting to be looked up to. I'm not sure I'm quite ready for that responsibility, and I'm sure that I'm going to mess with a bunch of first years, even inadvertently. And, you know, it's part of the college experience.
When I first moved here about a year ago, I didn't know that many people in the U.S. And now I can, like, actually say that I have a family here, and it's quite nice.
Like, that's something I actually appreciate about Booth House. They, like, made me feel pretty cozy pretty fast.
When I was told at age 12 or 13, that I'm going to go to college, I'm going to live in a dorm with a lot of people on my floor who are going to have to share a bathroom, that I was really terrified that I wouldn't know the people and that I was going to be alone and that it was going to be a really hard experience living on my own, having to do my own laundry, having to eat. But they never mentioned that I'd actually know all the people who live near me and that we'd all get along well and have our own different relationships, and it's really wonderful. It's really wonderful.
Yeah. Not a lot of people chose iHouse or Booth House even, but it makes for, like, a unique group of students living together, and we really make it work really well.
Yeah, Christine always says that, like, in her, like, classes and clubs, like, that's when you find your friends, but Booth House is, like, your home.
Family.
And your family. And I like that.
Yeah.
A Disney movie once said, "Ohana means family, and family means no one gets left behind." Well, in Booth, we leave each other behind a lot. But it is still family of sorts.
Yes. I think the Booth House is a very special collection of individuals, and I'm very glad to be able to call this place my home.
Booth House Cold House!
Booth House Flake House!
Booth House Fire Alarm House.
Booth House Lounge House, even though I haven't been in the lounge as much this quarter, but even so.
Booth House Domestic House. Booth House Together House.
Booth House Bomb Ass House.
Booth House Love House. I love Booth House.
Booth House Best Friends House.
This is a really Bradley prompted documentary.
Well, he rubs my belly and I pay him. Next.
Strave. I'm Jason. I have Booth House.
You know, I've always liked when you rub my belly.
I think you just film me doing this and him talking.
Please, I can't be seen with you.
Okay. Booth House, did you know Mansuade was an insurgent house? That was also lame.
You realize Sebastian was a first year? Like, winter quarter?
No, like end of autumn quarter. It wasn't that
okay, long. Okay. What about Zach Krebs? You definitely thought he was,
I thought,
like,
he was a first year until, like, like winter quarter.
Yeah, the first year winter quarter. We're better than Phoenix.
What are you guys gonna miss the most from leaving Booth House?
My boyfriend living upstairs.
Booth House, and then us as, like, the overlords. That's how I've always seen it.
Okay. Just one friend. Only one friend in this whole house.
However, one problem I have with this house is how flaky we all are. Okay, like, this is actually, like, hashtag Booth House Flake House. Like, we could not get a single activity together. So next year, like, we're gonna do activities, goddammit, and we're gonna, like, have picnics, and it's gonna be really cute, and no more flaking. Because I really want to do things with you guys, and you guys are just not, you know, being housey. So we're gonna be housey next year, so be ready for that.
But, like, the Chinese national anthem, I think, wins most innovative.
Looking at me from the prison. Peace.